that's one thing I wouldn't see. Like right now with all the fighters that I have, I don't want to bring one to jump them from one place. And I think they all know that too, and they don't want me to be like that. I think even promoters, you know, they don't want to see a manager going jumping from one to the other.
It's a trust thing too.
You know,
yeah.
I have my fighters with
the trainer, amateurs, and each of them. They're professional fighters now.
They're doing good. You know, it's my job to sometimes maybe yes. You know,
nah, my dad
with you know this whoever I have to deal with over there, where I have to go back and forth, negotiate. We do that. But it's not like because we don't like each other. It's just the way this business is. If it's with Brad, you know, just calling me, or the attorney Harrison or whoever it is, those are pretty much who I deal with the most. It's you know, of course sometimes we might not agree on some things, but there was Brad. He's gonna come to our show Friday. He's coming to our show. He's asking if we're gonna train early. I say, oh yeah, we're gonna train first. Oh, then we'll be at the gym first, and from there we'll go to the fight. You know what I mean?
Brad's fucking badass. That is pound for pound the coolest person in boxing.
He's cool. You know what I mean?
Brad Goodman, number one.
So you are.
He's a good man.
Oh, he's the coolest dude.
No, his name, Goodman.
Is there? Others that are good, as good, or maybe even better, you know.
Yeah,
what I mean? But we work with everybody. We work with
you have to. You have 30 pro fighters.
And like I said, and I'm happy that you see it here. Okay, we have four or five with Golden Boy. We have another five or six with Top Rank. We have PBC. We have
Ringstar.
Matchroom,
and The Zone,
Take it.
And
Garcia Promotions,
and
EsNews,
our own, you know, our own fighters. I'm never here telling the other one, you know, oh fuck,
that's true. You're right. There's no jealousy.
They're all doing good. Maybe some got a better contract than the others. Maybe you know, maybe there's some that came to me before. You know, after
they joke. They joke about it. Because like Espino signed with Eddie Hearn, he got a good signing bonus, he gets a good monthly
good
salary and good purses and stuff like that. And it's like a joke in there where we go in there and we talk shit to Espino about it. We're like, we see him with like a new chain or something, we're like, fuck, this motherfucker's paying you way
Robert,
too much money.
Robert, we did a video with him, it has like shit. Almost a million views about how to spend money. Do you think he learned how to spend his money?
Hell no.
He's gonna...
But right now, look, me, Espino. I also like to tell my guys, you know, Josito Lopez, we'll talk to him about it.
Yeah.
And he's already been asked, you know, hey, give me the number to so-and-so so I could talk to him, maybe do some investments, okay. But, you know, for him, it's good money because he gets a month
every month. Yeah.
And his purses are bigger than any other fighter I've ever.
Espino. That's like, awesome. Good for him. He's a good kid.
I think so. Who else? Nobody.
Tanahara was making
sense. Oh, yeah, maybe Tanahara.
But okay. He's one of the few. I get it.
Yeah. So,
I'm 24 years old.
But I'm not gonna tell him.
How old is he?
I'm saying I'm 24. Oh. Put some money, you know. It's not a lot, you know. Once if I see that at you know when he's already making a couple hundred thousand and he's fucking it up like that, then I'll tell him no.
There's no need to buy $1,200 shoes.
Put some over here.
They're $900.
Do this, do that. Then I'm right
tax
now. There's nothing I
fees.
Can really tell him. You know, it's not that much money where it's gonna make him.
Robert,
he's going to save money for the rest of his life.
I saw Teddy Atlas was talking shit about the WBC. He said that he went to Canal Street to buy fake purses and he bought a fake WBC belt and the buckle fell off.
But it was probably fake.
No, he was talking about like they give out their belts.
Why would they make them? They're giving them out.
But why is he hating? Isn't he half a WBC champion?
Yeah,
too much money on
shoes.
He just likes to say things like controversial.
Gym and you dress shoes.
But look, the knowledge you have, Robert,
Tanahara,
you can't buy.
Tanahara.
Yeah.
Great contract, good bonus and everything. Young when he got it. So, I'm not saying for him it was a lot, but in the big picture it wasn't a lot. You know,
it's all relative.
That's not enough to be good for the rest of
Mikey.
So enjoy it. Buy your shoes, whatever you want. Do all that you...
To motivate you.
That you want because you never had before, do it. But as the fights go by, when the time comes where his purses are gonna be much better, or if he ever makes it to world championship fights, where purses will be a lot better, then yes, I'm not gonna let them go and just.
No, but it wasn't.
Fuck up
it wasn't
their money.
A gift.
Okay. Something else?
Yeah.
And fuck up their money. Right now, it's still not a lot of money. So okay, have fun, enjoy.
Enjoy. No, I'm joking, but it's a mindset too. So.
And then I paid him for fighting.
But Espino's a special kid. Robert, everybody's different in this sport. And you could be, let's say, like Teofimo Lopez. When they signed him, they didn't think he's going to be this big. And he's proven everybody wrong by hard work and good fights. Sometimes you sign a kid at the Olympics who won a medal and he doesn't...
And doesn't do nothing.
Goes the wrong way. We've seen it both ways.
I've seen promoters sign and give a lot of money to gold medalists and then they lose.
They don't pan out.
They get knocked down.
And then you have a kid like Brandon Rios who made probably 10, 12, 15 million and no one gave him a shot.
Nobody gave him a
shot. They didn't think he was going to ever, oh, this kid's this and that.
Yeah, nobody gave him a shot. At
Pacquiao too? Yeah. Nobody thought Pacquiao would be the legend.
That's the way boxing is, man. Boxing is crazy, man.
What do you mean? Like, we
boxing is, now we see that way, like my dad always says, from all the ones that we have, we could say which ones are probably the best and say, okay, this three or four are the best.
Okay, see how many times.
But the one that we least expect is probably the one that could really make it.
It's true.
Back then, when we were in our gym, I would probably say that Brandon would have probably been the one that, back in Oxnard, in the Oxnard years, Brandon would have probably been the one that we least expected, maybe. I would probably say that.
And he became crazy famous.
Because we had some fucking talented dudes.
I remember. You had the Dominican guy that fought like Mayweather.
And then,
the 135, yes, Hernanes Mendez and Caballo Blanco out of the Olympics.
And then we had,
really?
He sent me to New York to see him.
What about the kid who looked like Canelo, the white boy, the homeschool kid?
Cameron doesn't go to the fights.
Yeah.
So he sent me to New York to go see Hernanes Mendez fucking fight when he turned pro. I was like, cool, this motherfucker is bad.
Robert Easter knocked him out.
And then we had some very talented guys in Austin, man. You know. Rolando Reyes was fucking talented.
Yep.
People was never around big fights or anything that big, but he was fucking talented. Jose Aguiniga was fucking talented.
Was he 35-0 or something like that?
Yeah, Jose Aguiniga.
32.
His brother, Mario Aguiniga, was probably a little bit better than his brother. But, you know.
You had Dave Rodell in the area.
A lot of fighters in Oxnard, okay? But that we had, because we never had Dave Rodell.
Okay.
Felipe Campa was fucking strong. Great power. Terror este Madrigal.
Who's that? Good. Which one is that?
Those actually two brothers that didn't turn pro that were also really good. Oh, Danny Perez. He fought Margarito twice. I think he had a draw with Margarito. Changa, Danny Perez, our guy. You know what? So we have a lot of talent in our town, man. A lot of talent. But not all of them make it.
No.
You know what I mean?
Same thing like in NBA. It's a lot of sports. It's like that.
I'm telling you, and with Brandon, with you know his trouble, his problems, all this and that, whatever. You might think, he's probably the one with the list. And out of everybody, those that I didn't even mention, because I'm sure I forgot a few.
He went the furthest.
He's the one that made the
fought Pacquiao.
He fought
Danny Garcia.
He went the furthest.
Fought Tim Bradley.
Made more money than
he beat Canelo's brother.
Than anybody else.
Lara had.